Rachel's experiencing fear at the sight of dogs as a result of her emotional memory or learned emotional reaction. Another example of this would be the shame that you feel when someone mentions a test that you cheated on. This fear is created by an episodic memory, or memory of personally experienced events. She's recalling the time that she was attacked by a dog when she was younger.
Are you alright?
I'm not coming in there.
Why not?
I'm afraid of dogs.
Why?
I was attacked by a dog on November 29th, 2005.
Rachel's semantic memory is working when she recalls this date. Semantic memory consists of memories of facts and concepts, such as the capital of New Jersey, or basic mathematical skills like addition and subtraction.
Well, that doesn't mean Roxy's gonna hurt you. She's never gonna hurt you. She's a really nice dog.
I'm leaving anyway. Bye.
Rachel is using her procedural memory, or motor skills and habits, to drive away. She no longer thinks about how to drive because it has become as routine as brushing her teeth. She didn't wait. They decided to work on the project at Rachel's house.
Okay, guys, so we have to explain the types of short-term and long-term memory.
All right, so what are the types of short-term memory?
Well, there are none. Short-term memory processes select information from the sensory registers. It's known as working memory because it can only be stored for an instant.
Ugh, this is so boring. I have a serious problem. I'm gonna fail gym if I can't win the Macarena by Monday.
Okay, well, we can teach you. How have you tried before?
I watched the whole video, and then I tried it myself.
Just taking it out on one, two, turn the hand three, and four, hand to shoulder, five, six, and seven, eight, on the hips, one, two, on the bottom, three, four.
Well, you should try chunking.
Ew, that sounds gross.
No, chunking just means grouping information so that it's easier to handle and understand.
What do you mean?
Well, we can teach you.
Okay, Rachel, we're going to start by chunking the moves into the parts of the body you use, okay?
All right.
Yay.
Okay. So we're going to start with the upper half, your arms. So you're going to put them out straight, one, two, and then out, three, four. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay. You going to do it again?
All right.
Okay. One, two, three, four. And then we're going to use this part of our body. We're going to go five, six, seven, eight.
Are you ready for the second half of the dance?
Let's do it.
Okay, so your hands are up here, and then we're going to use the bottom half of your body, like around your hips. So you're going to go and take your right hand and go to the opposite hip, and then butt, butt, and then shake it. And that's Macarena. Okay, so if your hands are up here, you go hip, hip, butt, butt, shake it.
That sounds easy enough.
Don't you get it now?
Yeah.
Want to try it all together?
Let's do it.
All right, let's get started. Are you ready to do this with music?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yay! I'm gonna pass gym now! Thanks, guys, that really helped.
The only way that you'll get better is if you keep practicing over and over. Use this technique called rote rehearsal to remember the dance.
Well, the Macarena in itself is actually an example of rote rehearsal because you just keep doing it over and over again.
Will it help me remember on Monday?
Yes, this technique will be helpful in remembering info for both short and long term.
Wow, thanks.
Y'all can work on our project.
Yes.
Okay, do you know what LTM is?
Isn't that your permanent memory, like the stuff you just know?
Yeah, it's divided into two categories, implicit and explicit. Implicit
memory is the info that we can't readily express in words. We may not be aware of these memories, and they cannot be readily accessed. They consist of procedural and emotional memories.
So that means explicit must be somatic and episodic memories, right?
Yes, explicit memory is memory for information that we can readily express in words or are aware of having. We can intentionally retrieve these memories.
Okay, that makes sense. I think I understand the information. Now can we start the video?
Yes.
Yay.
The end.